mourning the death of both her father, Alistair, and brother, Mark, whose funerals took place this afternoon. They died within 8 days of each other last month from COVID. Elaine, who's a musician, believes her dad caught COVID in hospital and passed it to her brother. Both had long-term health conditions. Now, she claims, a senior doctor at Northumbria Healthcare Trust has apologised and promised an investigation. That's not been confirmed by the Trust, which says it can't give details on the case because of patient confidentiality. Our news correspondent, Mark Denton, joins us now from Wicklow Bay.
Lots of sunshine.
Well, Carol, over 12,000 people in the northeast Cumbria and North Yorkshire have sadly died with COVID. But, you know, it's the images as much as the raw numbers that are as powerful. And in 2 years of covering this story, to be honest, I've seen few more poignant sights than this one. Two coffins of a father and his son arriving for their joint funeral this afternoon. Now, both Alistair and Mark Rennie live together here in Whitley Bay. Both of them died with COVID, and now their family are asking for some answers. Elaine is mourning her father and brother. Alistair and Mark both died from COVID just 8 days apart last month.
Obviously, I'm brokenhearted. It's like they're absolutely terrible. As my whole family wiped out, there's only me left.
Elaine believes her father contracted COVID when he was a patient at North Tyneside Hospital and tested positive when he got home. She thinks he gave COVID to Mark, who had MS. They both lived in the same house. Now she says she's been contacted by a senior doctor at Northumbria Healthcare Trust.
Well, he says, I'm the senior doctor from emergency care, and he says, I'm phoning because we're doing a hospital investigation to see about the deaths of your dad and brother. And he says, so obviously he's gone home, passed it to your brother, and I have sincere apologies about that.
Now, Northumbria Healthcare Trust would not confirm whether an investigation is going on into how Alistair contracted COVID, followed by his son, Mark. They also would not confirm whether a senior doctor had apologised to Elaine, but they did issue this statement. It says, one of our senior clinicians has been in touch with Elaine to offer our sincere condolences and support, as well as to help respond to her concerns. Due to patient confidentiality, we cannot comment any further.
Daddy, you know I love you, Daddy.
As a musician, Elaine has now written a song in tribute to her father, which she performed at the funerals this afternoon. Her music helping her as she mourns the two men closest to her. Well, Northumbria Health Service Trust have also told us, Carol, that the COVID-19 testing process has changed during the pandemic. They go on the emergency patients, they say, were routinely tested for COVID on days 1, 3, and 7, and if they had clinical symptoms or infection concerns as well. They say patients are also tested if they were transferred to another care environment that required testing. Back to you.
Thank you, Mark.